We'll have live reports from Kabul and much more on this India Today News Today special. But first, the nine headlines at nine tonight. Horror unfolds at Kabul airport as desperate Afghans climb onto US planes taking off. Two locals fall to death. At least three more killed in gunfire at the airport. Indian Air Force aircraft land in Kabul to evacuate citizens. The Taliban occupy the Afghanistan presidential palace. Ashraf Ghani flees to Oman reportedly. Pakistan Prime Minister Imran Khan says Taliban has broken the shackles of slavery. United Nations Security Council holds an emergency meeting over the Taliban takeover in Afghanistan. UN Secretary General Antonio Guterres appeals to countries to give refuge to the Afghans. Rahul Gandhi's close aide and Mahila Congress chief Sushmita Dev dumps the party, joins the Trinamool Congress. Kapil Sibal now hits out at the Congress leadership, says they are working with their eyes shut. Supreme Court asked the centre to file an affidavit on whether the government used Pegasus spyware or not. The Modi government says it will appoint a panel to snoop to probe the Snoopgate claims. Centre allocates 267 crore emergency COVID relief fund to Kerala. Union Health Minister Mansukh Mandavia in Thiruvananthapuram to review the situation on ground in the state with the highest number of COVID cases. Finance Minister Nirmala Sitharaman refuses to cut excise duty and petrol and diesel for now, says burdened by UPA-era oil bonds. Unrest grows in Shillong over an ex-militant's death. Petrol bombs are hurled at Meghalaya Chief Minister Sangma's house. State Home Minister quits as violence and arson grip Shillong. Chasing 272, England lose half their side as India push for a historic victory in the Lord's Test. Shami is the batting hero.